Hello. Okay. Hi everyone, I'm Elvis John. I'm from Inhalt Innovations and this is your first training video. So in this training video, we are going to discuss basically the format and the framework which we use while working. Let me introduce what actually Inhalt Innovations does. So Inhalt Innovations is a content management firm and we partner with SEO companies. Now what is SEO? SEO is search engine optimization. What is the operations of search engine optimization companies? Now if you already know that there are several websites available on the internet, okay? Let's pick a niche. Say cycle developers, cycle manufacturers, bicycle manufacturers. So there are X number of companies who manufacture cycles domestically or say internationally. Each of these manufacturers have their own website and they have to maintain an online presence in order to attract more clients. So the operations of an SEO company is to elevate the ranking of a particular website on search engine platforms, okay? So that say company DBZ appears in the first page of Google when anyone is looking to purchase a bicycle online. Okay, so that is what SEO companies are primarily doing. Now, in order to elevate the rank of a particular website, proper authentic content is required. Content should be of good quality, should have relevant keywords, and should also possess relevant information. With the help of these three things, Google will scan each and every content which is present on a particular website, and based on the relevance and the authentic information which is already present about a particular article or a blog or a web page, the website rank automatically increases and it features in the first couple pages of Google. So this is what we do. We write content for SEO firms. Okay. There are two things which you guys have to be clear about before starting the internship. First is plagiarism. Now what is plagiarism? Plagiarism is nothing but copy pasting someone else's work and representing it as your own. This aspect of plagiarism is considered to be a very big crime in our industry. So please try to avoid that. We understand that you will require information from external sources, but you guys are smart enough. So what you will do is read, understand, interpret the information which you are taking from other websites and present it in your own words. That is how you will avoid plagiarism. Okay, another thing which I have to address is content spinning. Now what is content spinning? Let's say for example, today you are writing an article which is about digital marketing. Okay, 500 words on digital marketing. And tomorrow also you are working on a similar assignment which also deals with the similar domain and the niche of digital marketing. So what certain interns do is that the work which I had done yesterday with regards to digital marketing, I will provide the same work again today. That is wrong. That is to be avoided at all cost. You are required to provide fresh content on a daily basis. Spinning your own content on a regular basis is a big crime. Okay, so what the clients want is fresh content at all times. So once if you have already written about digital marketing, let's say advantages of digital marketing yesterday, today you're going to talk about features of digital marketing. So keep your options open. What you want to write about, that's up to you. What we are going to do is provide you titles or maybe keywords, but how you proceed with an assignment, it completely depends on you. So this is where you get the creative freedom of providing unique content. So make full utilization of that. Rather than spinning your own content, make sure to provide fresh content at all times. So if you guys have any queries regarding SEO, plagiarism and content spinning, please do let me know, WhatsApp me or give me a call. Now moving on, we primarily work with keywords. Now you guys must be asking yourselves, like, what is a keyword? How do we use it? Now keyword is nothing but a particular term which a person is most likely to type on search engine platforms. Okay, let's say for example, I want to purchase a mobile phone online. Okay, so what is the first thing which I'm going to do? I'm going to go on Google and I'm going to check what mobile phones are available online. Okay, so we are going to do that. Typing in the keyword now. Okay. Now if you see, mobile phone online, Amazon is showcasing the keyword mobile phone online on Google itself. I have highlighted that on the screen. I hope you guys can see. Again, if we scroll down further, you will see Snapdeal also has a similar keyword, mobile phones online. So what Google is doing, like I said before, the keyword, whatever word I am typing on this search bar of Google, Google will scan the relevant content which is available on the internet, and based on the relevance of the content and the information present on a particular website, it ranks the website, which has the best information, and showcases it in the first couple pages of the search engine platform. So this is what keywords are. Now what we have to do is use the keywords which the client will provide us, the SEO companies will provide us, and we have to use it to form content, to write articles and blogs. So I'm hoping this point is clear as well. Again, if you have any other queries or doubts regarding keywords, please do let me know. So yesterday, we had sent you a mail, all you need to know about Inhalt Innovations. Now this mail is very, very important because it is the basic guideline on how do we process a particular assignment. Okay, I'm going to analyze this now. So first of all, this is the basic structure of using the keywords present. Okay, so normally what happens is that the client will give us, say, X number of keywords, 1, 2, 3, let's say 3 keywords they have given. What we have to do is pick one as a primary keyword and pick second as the secondary keyword, and we have to use it accordingly. Like over here it's mentioned the basic rule, okay. Use the primary keyword in the title. Okay, then again, the primary keyword is to be highlighted in the first paragraph or the introduction. Use proper subheadings in every content. Subheads are important. The secondary keyword which you have picked out of the three, say XYZ, you're picking X as the primary and Z as the secondary. So the secondary keyword you have to use twice anywhere in the content. Okay, out of 500 words you can use the secondary content maybe in the middle, in the body of an article, okay, twice. And again the primary keyword is going to feature in the last paragraph. So this is the basic instruction when nothing has been mentioned to you. If tomorrow I give you, say, 2 keywords and I tell you give me an article, what you have to do is formulate a title with the help of the keyword and give me 500 word content. Taking the example of this keyword, mobile phone online, if I give you the keyword, say, mobile phone online and mobile phones online, these are the 2 keywords, you have to form a title out of this. How do we do that? So let's say for example, I want to write about 5 unique advantages of purchasing mobile phone online. You guys are seeing what I'm doing. I am using the keyword which has been given to me, which is mobile phone online, and I'm using it to form a title. 5 unique advantages of purchasing mobile phone online. Okay, so I create a title, first point has been met. When I'm writing the introduction, I'm going to use mobile phone online again in the introduction. I'm going to use subheads. My secondary keyword is mobile phones online. Okay, I'm going to use that twice anywhere in the content. And again, my primary keyword, which is mobile phone online, I'm going to use it in the conclusion. Okay, so this is the basic keyword usage instruction which you guys have to follow most of the times. Okay, unless and until the client tells you to use the keyword only once or maybe 10 times, then we are going to follow what the client is demanding. Okay, but when nothing has been mentioned, we take it for granted that this basic instruction has to be utilized. Okay, now moving on to the different type of articles, different type of content we provide. Okay, so there are generally 4 to 5 different sort of articles which we write. First is the article type, is an article of course. While writing an article, you have to keep in mind that you have to write in a very professional manner. Okay, words such as wanna, you, I, is supposed to be avoided. Professional terms are to be used, which is to be backed up with stats and figures and relevant terms. Okay, so it's more or less like a newspaper article, very formal. You're addressing a client, you're providing information, it has to be informative. Okay, so keeping that in mind, an article is to be composed. Now a blog is completely different to an article. It will be very informal. You have to engage the reader. Okay, you have to ask questions. It's almost like you're having a conversation with the reader. Okay, so you can ask questions like, are you looking for whatever, blah blah blah, something of that sort. It will have a narrative tone. Okay, so that is how a blog is composed. Now company profile is nothing but let's just say it's equivalent to a Wikipedia page. If you go to any Wikipedia page and try to find information about a particular topic, you will see the writing format is very informative. It will say that it, let's say if you want to research about Inhalt innovations on Wikipedia, you know information regarding when Inhalt innovations was established, who's the CEO, what is being done, what is the operations of Inhalt innovations, how many employees are working for Inhalt innovations, what are they planning to do. So basically you have to cover the operations of a firm or a product, whatever you are writing about, in company profile. These bullet points will help you out as well. Just go through it once again. Press release is again a little different from any other type of content which we provide. Press release is more or less fictional sort of thing, okay, where you will discuss and write about the activities of a company. Let's say Inhalt Innovations, for example, is now looking to collaborate with international SEO companies. Okay, now this becomes a headline. It's a new activity which we are looking to expand into, and while writing a press release, you can exploit this. So first of all, an introduction is going to come in a press release where you generally address a particular situation. So if you're writing about Inhalt Innovations and content management industry, you will talk about, let's say, the content management industry is very essential for digital marketing, blah blah blah. You go into the normal details of an introduction. Then you come to the point, what is actually being addressed? What is Inhalt Innovations doing? Inhalt Innovations is looking to expand and collaborate with international SEO companies, which is a big step for an Indian company, as not many firms are, you know, brave enough to venture into the unknown and collaborate with international firms. So this is like a new trend which we are looking to set in terms of domestic economy. Okay, so while you are writing this, you will address this. Again, certain quotes, they're going to appear. Now these quotes are completely fictional. Okay, like say Mr. XYZ, the CEO of Inhalt Innovations, stated that our company is whatever. This quote, you can make it out of your head. It's not necessary that you have to take an interview of a particular person and quote them. No, this quote can be made out of your head. Generally, we use 2 quotes in every PR, which is of approximately of 50 words each. So that helps a lot to expand the word count. Okay, so that was press release. Again, if you guys have any queries or doubts, first of all, go through all the samples which we have attached in the same mail chain itself. Read through it, you guys will get a better idea. Moving on to web content. Okay, while writing web content, you guys have to keep one thing in mind, that you have to write as if you are the company. Okay, terms such as our services, our team of experts, we provide the best services. It's almost like you are the company and you are writing about yourself. Okay, so that web content tone has to be used. Normally in web content, what we do is write about the about us section of a company. Okay, the services provided of a company, contact us, the home page, etc., etc. So the tone which is to be used in a web page is very, very important. Again, sections like why choose us, mission, our vision, all these things will come into play when you're writing web content. Samples are attached. Kindly go through it again. Now, the basic format of writing. Okay. Now, we write in Calibri. Okay. The title has to be appeared in font size 12 Calibri, and you have to bold it. Highlight that in bold. We use justified line alignment. If you guys don't know how to justify line alignment, just press Ctrl A, then press Ctrl J on Microsoft Word, or if you're working on Google Doc, Ctrl Shift J will get you to justified line alignment. That is pretty much it in terms of writing. Line spacing is 1.15. Please keep that in mind. Again, if your word count, word target is 500 words, please make sure to write at least a minimum of 500 words, okay? Not less than that. But also do not exceed 550 to 600 at the maximum. 550 is preferable. So when a word count, a word target has been provided to you guys of 500 words, make sure a minimum of 500 words is provided. Okay? Another thing which you guys have to keep in mind, while writing an article, blog or whatever, always focus on the positive aspects. Do not write about, say, disadvantages of purchasing mobile phone online, limitations of purchasing mobile phone online. Do not do that. Okay, so the client does not want the negative aspects to be featured. If you are working for someone, you will not focus on the negative parts, right? You'll always try to focus on, say, the facts and figures, or keeping it general, or rather the advantages and not the disadvantages. Okay, so please make sure this is, you know, maintained at all times. So this is, I guess, all for now. I'm going to follow up with a second video where I'm going to discuss how a particular assignment is to be processed. Your new jobs are going to be assigned very soon, and please go through this video again if you guys have any queries, and text me or WhatsApp me whenever you want.